Listen.
In places like in the Arctic, where indigenous people sometimes might hunt a wolf, they'll take a double-edged blade and they'll put blood on the blade and they'll melt the ice and stick the handle in the ice so that only the blade is protruding, and that a wolf will smell the blood and wants to eat, and it'll come and lick the blade trying to eat. And what happens is when the wolf licks the blade, of course, he cuts his tongue and he bleeds and he thinks he's really having a good meal. He drinks and he licks and he licks, and of course he's drinking his own blood and he kills himself. That's what the imperialists did to us with crack cocaine. You got these young brothers out there thinking that they're getting something that they're gonna make a living with. They're getting something they can buy a car. Like the white people have cars, why can't I have a car? They're getting something that they can get a piece of gold. The white people have gold, why can't I have gold? They're getting something to get a house. The white people have a house, why can't I have a house? And they actually think that it's something that's bringing resources to them, but they're killing themselves just like the wolf who's licking the blade, and they're slowly dying without knowing it. That's what's happening to the community. You with me on that? That's exactly and precisely what happens to the community. And instead of blaming the hunter who put the damn handle and the blade in the ice for the wolf, that what happens is the wolf gets blamed for trying to live. That's what happens in our community. You don't blame the person, the victim, you blame the oppressor. Imperialism, white power, is the enemy. Was the enemy when it first came to Africa and snatched up the first African, brought us here against our will, is the enemy today. That's the thing that we have to understand. And now upon that,
I'll say something. You people, you're not a race. You are a virus. You destroy the world. Everything beautiful you poison. You drag us from our homes, you rape our daughters, murder our sons. You crack our spines and do all you can to break our will. You stab us. Then you put the knife in our hand and tell us it's our fault. And if you don't do it yourself, you stand by, close your eyes, and pretend there's nothing wrong. And then you pray to your God to silence our screams so that you can enjoy the happiness that we built for you with our blood. But it's not your fault. It's the only way you know how to be. And the only thing that will change anything is if another virus comes along and does to you what you do to us. And I hope that happens very soon.
Wow. This evening obviously hasn't gone as I'd hoped. And I think I'm having a full-on panic attack right now. So I'm going to go to the bathroom and get myself together. And when I come back, I hope you don't see me as the devil.
When we took over the world, we decided to use the most dangerous weapon of all to subjugate the darker peoples of the planet. We used a combination of white supremacy and religion to mindfuck these people into complete submission. If a robber breaks into your house, rapes your family, kills your mother and father, then tells you that in order to go to heaven, you have to worship his God. If someone did that to me, then said that to be born again, I had to worship his God, I'd kill the bastard right on the spot. But you black people seem to have no problem worshipping the god of your enemies. Even worse is the fact that for all the praying that you have done, it seems like the god of the white man is just as racist as we are. Anytime you start believing in the god of your enemy, it pretty much means you're a complete idiot and a pussy, who is too far gone to confront his adversary.